following hometown program is brought to you in living color on WBBZ-TV.
Welcome back to the Daily Buzz 716. I'm Adriana Vivarette-Gambo, and welcome to the Erie County Fair. Now, you already know we're in for another spectacular show. We're going to get the scoop on what's going on when it comes to the music from a featured performer. Of course, we're going to teach you how to eat healthy while here at the fair. And all I got to say is our folks from Independent Health got this display looking so great. I can't wait. And, oh, we have an ultimate fair goer who's going to let us know all about the fair from her perspective. And it all starts right now. Now, this is a dangerous question to always ask. Ladies, what's on your mind?
Well, we wanted to mention, we're at the fair. We're so excited to be here. Hi, everybody.
Absolutely.
And today is Firefighters First Responders Day.
They're going to do a parade.
And every year, they honor the first responders from all over the community. Mm-hmm. And they have a big parade in the grandstand tonight at 7 o'clock. And thousands of people are here in honor of them and thousands of participants. We saw them lining up when we came at the gate. Firefighters and from, like I said, every district around here, it's very, very moving and exciting.
It really is.
I've been there to see it go, see them going around sort of endlessly.
I love how you and Adriana say, firefighters and our first responders are heroes because while everyone else is running out,
they're running in. And I say that all the time because when I was younger, my house caught on fire. And I never forget being a kid, like, they're bringing out, like, my Barbies. That's, like, a little bit of melted because I kept just yelling about my Barbies, right? But I was always amazed, like, everybody's running out, you're running in, so thank you for saving my Barbies.
And so everyone come on out.
Yes, tonight at 7 o'clock.
Absolutely. But don't make a big traffic jam. Come at different times or something.
Oh, yeah, but come out wherever you are.
Only judge would say that. Yes. And also, something else great has happened in Buffalo. We're all familiar with ALS.
Yes, now, you know what's funny is that for a point of time, no clue what it was. But the great thing about it is I love the aspect of social media because it became this huge viral thing when it became the challenge, and that's how I became aware of ALS. Now let's talk about what has just happened right now in this moment.
So I do want to say it's the first drug treatment approved by the FDA specifically for ALS in 22 years, happening for the first time in Buffalo, New York.
Amazing.
Dent Tower. We have two people getting the treatment. Now this treatment is supposed to delay the effects of it for up to 33%.
Okay.
So this is significant.
Right.
Very, very, very significant.
Any delay we can have when it comes to it is great.
Yes.
Absolutely.
You know,
so. Absolutely. In Buffalo, New York.
Yes,
go ahead,
of course. Well, and from there, you know, hopefully they'll, as research progresses and as they use experimentally, they may find a cure.
Absolutely.
And this is big because ALS affects the nerve cells in the brain and the spinal cord, and it can lead to muscle loss, control, total paralysis, and even death. So this disease is not a light disease.
And as we know, so many people have suffered from it and died from it, and well-known people and people in the community.
Right.
So this is just really very, very, very
great
important.
Great news.
So, that.
So now here's, I don't know if this is great news or bad news.
Let's talk about it. Let's hear it, Judge. So,
in a nod to the Heights, which is the University Heights, it says, UB reroutes the drunk bus.
Now, you know, I'm a UB alum. I get very sensitive. So I'm like, what you about to say about UB?
Mm-hmm.
What I do know is when I was in school, 05 to 09, had to put that out there, we had the stampede that took us from the South Campus to the North Campus. Now, this must be something new because you said they're being dropped off in the Heights?
Yes. It's not new, though. I guess it's been going on for a while.
Oh, really?
And
after I graduated.
The issue. Maybe it was there and you didn't know.
I know, right? I was
Adriana didn't party.
It's not the stampede bus that takes them shopping and takes the students all over the shuttle. The point of it is, it's a bus that was running continuously at night until very late in the night, taking students from UB to the university district, where they were going to look for parties, house parties, because the students, as you know, are living in the university district.
I've had my fair share of house parties in that district.
So Yes. Can we leave that part out? Okay.
I had fun
okay,
in college.
Jen.
But the bus
no,
was...
but
go
the
ahead.
Students were very upsetting to the neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And you were not
yes.
doing this, Adriana.
Yeah,
you know.
Know,
they were the neighbors who were not students mm-hmm. who were living there.
Right.
They were, I don't know how to say this, but they were also calling it the vomit comet.
Mm.
So you can imagine what was going on in the neighborhood, and they
yeah.
were knocking on doors and
right.
making loud noise and whatever. So they're going to try to eliminate that a little bit by having less frequent routes.
Right.
And not dropping them at the same place which
right.
Where they were dropping them
and
off.
And I feel like they should have just kept it at dropping you off at South Campus and then you being able to walk where you need to walk. Because I get what they were trying to do to make sure that anybody that was drinking, you don't have to drive or anything like that. But just
yes,
keep, yeah, that was the good, mm-hmm. you know, the focus of the whole shuttle. But if they just keep it, you just drop you off at South Campus and then you walk to where you need to. Then I think
and
that
there
would
is
be a good solution.
Exactly. There's a useful purpose,
right.
as you pointed
yeah.
out, because a lot of the students out in, what do they call it?
The North Campus.
They
mm-hmm.
don't have transportation.
Right.
You know, they're from out of town sometimes, and they can't get around. And they were, it's a useful purpose. They're taking them to the mall and to
yeah.
the movies and, you know, good things like that.
Yeah.
My only
but,
question is, how many of these young people are underage? Because you have to be 21, so if you're shuttling people that are under 21 around, That's
and,
my only question.
And of course, we already know the answer to that.
Somehow we doubt that when they get on the bus, that somebody, security or driver, says, can we see your ID, please?
Yeah. No.
I don't
yeah.
think that was happening.
Really
no, I don't
and
know.
I just remember when I was in college and I was like one out of all my friends who had the vehicle. Like you said, I had a lot of friends that were yeah. out of state. You know, I was the DD all the time, you know, driving to the different parties. And so, yeah.
Well, I mean, it has good and bad, but
yeah.
I think
yeah.
it's a good effort. And
it really
also
is.
to mollify the people who live in that neighborhood who have been, you know,
right.
upset. We had the councilman on not that long ago.
Wyatt.
He was
mm-hmm.
talking about that, remember? So
yes.
it's good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay,
and
ahead.
You know, speaking of UB, just last night, the Robert Randolph Band was at the Canal Side for Thursday. And what I love most is my first time seeing a Robert Randolph Band was at UB for our UB Fall Fest. And he was amazing. He was amazing last night. And I think it's great that we're having so many different artists and so many different concerts coming down to the Canal Side. So make sure you're still on the lookout of the different entertainment that is coming
mm-hmm.
right downtown.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And then just to change it up a little bit, I love this article in the Buffalo News that the judge brought. It says, want to be happy? Buy more takeout
yes.
and hire a maid.
Let me tell you, I agree. I'm all about outsourcing.
Okay.
Yeah. So
okay.
I don't call it outsourcing, Adriana. But it says to save time and reduce stress about the limited time,
mm-hmm.
Eating out more and hiring a maid can improve your happiness. And it's saying that no matter your income,
yes.
it was saying right. people find this very,
makes
very...
Them, yeah. Makes them happy. And they actually did a study. This
yeah.
makes me laugh. They'll do a study about everything, right? When I read this, headline, I'm like, hire a maid, take out, makes you happy. But we studied thousands of people, and we said to them, this says,
right.
we said to them, would you rather have material things? Would you rather us buy you, like, a new coat or jewelry or this?
Give
or would you rather use the money? Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
exactly.
I'll take the time.
This time is one of those commodities you can
never buy.
And anytime
said,
you
no,
can
I'd
get
rather
it back.
I'd rather have a maid.
I agree. You know, not even just eating out, but, you know, having someone prep your meals for
meal
you.
Meal prep, yeah.
Meal prepping, you
yeah.
know, anything to cut time to where you can actually focus on the things you want versus things you have to, I'm all for it. Mercedes, you can speak to that, being a wife, being a mother.
Yeah.
I can speak to it being busy and being a wife and having to do things, so I'm so with it.
Yeah.
We love this story.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
But I know we could go all day with this,
yeah.
but we have to take a
we
short
could.
Break. But when we come back, Judge Penny is going to talk with our ultimate fairgoer. And I know she's going to give us some things that we have no clue about. So stay with us.
Welcome back to the Daily Buzz 716. We are here with the ultimate fair goer, Mary Roberts. Now, we are so excited. We have been waiting since the fair opened to meet this famous person and to find out how she got crowned and what it means. Welcome.
Hi, thank you, Penny.
Thank you so much. So please tell us, how did you earn this title and the ribbon and the medallion, Ultimate Fairgoer 2017?
Well, every year the fair has a contest located on their Facebook saying that if they nominate, somebody could be nominated. So I posted it and shared it on my Facebook, and everybody decided to nominate me. I come every year, every day.
Well, I was going to say, there must be a reason. So explain to us what the criteria were and what they say you had to prove or show to be the ultimate fairgoer.
There really wasn't much criteria, honestly. They just wanted to know somebody that spends a lot of time at the fair, who enjoys it, you know. I don't really know, but that's pretty much all they asked.
All right, so now by spending a lot of time at the fair, we want to know, first of all, how long you've been coming and how often you come.
Every day for the past probably 10 years. My husband's been in the Demolition Derby for, this will be his 14th year. And I've had my kids, my daughter's been coming and my son's been coming since they've been born, every day.
Every day for 10 years.
So
you have had a lot of fair food, right?
Yes, I've had a lot of fair food.
So let's start with everybody's asking the same question. What is her favorite fair food?
Well, to be honest, my favorite are the gyros. They're sold pretty much everywhere. And the taco in the bag just came a couple years ago. I like that as well. The grilled cheese place up there, and there's a tater tot place that just came last year that's really good too.
Okay, we're trying to follow all these recommendations. What about activities, like besides eating and fair food, which is the ultimate, but what about activities like rides or the farm or, well, you mentioned the Derby, so.
Yeah, so every day we try to get here a little bit before noon because they do the feed a calf, so we try to get tickets for that for my kids to win that. We went to a couple shows yesterday. We went to the new Flippin' show, which was really good, and we did check out the balloon guy over here. He's excellent. He's been here the past few years. In regards to, I don't remember the last question you asked.
That was it. You know, what were your favorite activities and how, when you come, do you like come in the morning and stay the whole day or how does it work?
So we usually come like in the morning, right before noon. We stay for a few hours, catch a few shows. We'll go home for like a 4 o'clock dinner and then we'll come back in the evening and kind of close the fair.
And do you recognize all the people, like when you walk around and the different vendors and so, do they say, oh, hi, Mary, hi, Mary?
No, they don't really know. They don't know me, not yet.
Did you ever go to any other fairs to see, to compare?
I've been wanting to go to the state fair the past couple years. I haven't made it out there. It's just the summers get so busy. So no, I haven't been to any other fair besides this one. We actually live not even a quarter mile up the street, so it's kind of like in our backyard. We come a lot.
I was going to ask you that. Do you recognize, like when you come, do you see a lot of people that you've known over the years?
I see a lot of friends and family here all the time, yeah. Vendors as well. I mean, a lot of the vendors have been coming for many years. I don't know them personally, but you do recognize them from year to year.
Do you see improvements? Like one year it's something you think that maybe they should do better and then they do?
Actually, I'm really happy with the new gate 4 that they opened with the beautiful welcome to the fair sign. They used to have that gate open a few years back and then they stopped doing it and had it in between the casino and the ag center. So I'm really happy they brought that gate back. I like that a lot.
And what about entertainment? Has there been somebody you totally loved in the past and somebody coming that you love?
I like the German guy. He's been here a couple years as well. He's really funny. The balloon guy is hilarious. I like him as well. The flipping guy, the flipping thing is new, and they were really good. I like them. So I could see them coming back again.
Have they asked you which they should for suggestions, like besides the ones you said, that somebody you'd like to see come to the fair or something you'd like here that they don't have?
They haven't asked me for any suggestions yet, but I think I might mail them something after the fair and definitely give them a few suggestions.
No, tell them right now.
I can't think of them right now.
Oh, okay. Yes. They probably would listen to you. They would probably love it. Thank you so much.
Thanks,
We're
honey.
So honored to meet you, and thank you for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
We are going to be right back inside with the ladies for the Daily Buzz 716, so please stay with us.
Welcome back to the Daily Buzz 716. We're still at the fair, and I'm so excited because our next guest is both a composer and a producer, musician. He does it all, a true performer, and I'm so excited to have him here. A friend of the show, especially Mary Kate, we have Mr. Phil Sims. How are you?
Good morning, ladies.
I know. I love people introducing you like you're just that guy, that composer.
I love that introduction. You're going to follow me everywhere I go.
You know, guys, just we have me. Phil Sims here. He's performing at the fair all next week. Had a huge show last night. Great friend, awesome, iconic jazz performer. But wow. Let's take a look at a video and let his music tell the story.
Thanks, Mary Kate.
Isn't that the most amazing? Now, Bob, since you have moved back home, which we're so grateful.
Thank you. Yes.
For years and years, you were the brainchild and the big talent of the Buffalo Brass.
That was my baby, yes.
That was the big band. That's brought real big band. You played with some iconic performers. Let our audience remind them, actually, because I'm sure they were there.
Well, actually, the iconic performers are all Western New Yorkers, and Buffalo for years was a hotbed of talent that managed to get out into the world and travel with all the named big bands, the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra, the Glenn Miller Orchestra, the Maynard Ferguson Band, on and on and on, all from Buffalo. And of course, Buffalo's own Bobby Militello was Dave Brubeck's lead alto saxophone player longer than Paul Desmond, I might add. So Buffalo
Bobby's
has
awesome.
Always been a great music town and still is.
Yes. Absolutely. Now, my question, you know, that I ask anyone when it comes to their passion, how did you even step into wanting to be this man that makes and creates music?
Well, I was given lots of wonderful opportunities, both in school and, you know, music educators played a huge hand in that. Music teachers don't get paid nearly enough for the time and effort they put in.
Just a pitch out for the budget.
Just a pitch out for the budget.
And we agree.
But actually, the person who really got me going was my band leader from the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra, the late, great Buddy Morrow. And he gave me the opportunity to start writing for the band. And while I was on the band, I actually had Mel Torme sing some of my arrangements, which was really, really cool.
The
Velvet Fog, yeah. So, you know, those opportunities are what got me going. I'm really grateful for those. I'm incredibly grateful to be part of this, once again, part of the Buffalo music community, and so thrilled to be back.
We're
no
better
place,
having
no
you
place
back.
No place like Buffalo.
Now, is it a new group that you're here with, or is it one that you had before?
Newer.
Newer.
Yes. One, and I come bearing gifts.
Look.
Yes.
Hey.
So the first four nights of the fair, this might be kind of hard because it's a little tiny
print,
but this is the Bobby LaBelle Orchestra, and Bobby LaBelle is a two-time, Buffalo Music Hall of Fame inductee twice, once, so he's pretty good. Amazing guitarist, sponsored by Gretsch Guitars, and we put together a rockabilly big band with him, and it's very interesting because he's very Elvis rock and roll, and he's flanked by six of the best jazz horn players you can hear.
I've never heard of a rockabilly big band.
I love it.
I wish you were here yesterday. Elvis was here.
Phil Sims is in the building.
The next four nights, when Bobby finishes, we just saw the video of Katie Miner and the Cabaret Big Band, which was actually the brainchild of our good friend Randy Kramer, who runs Musical Fair.
We're doing
a big show with Katie and the band at Musical Fair on August 19th. Katie Miner sings Sinatra.
Wow.
So come on out to Musical Fair when this fair is over.
Katie Miner's awesome.
And then the last four nights, the 18-piece big band that is playing is run by a gentleman named Pete Cirillo, who taught for years at Lakeshore High School. He directed me in my first ever high school jazz ensemble, the 1972 Erie County All-County High School Jazz Ensemble, and he's still going. And he's running an amazing big band. But somebody else had an amazing big band.
I just want to see. We have some vinyl here.
Vinyl is back.
Oh, wow. From the Buffalo Brass.
You like you're all about that. The vinyl.
Yeah, I'm so about vinyl.
And if you wonder who that is, it is not. It is Phil Simms with hair.
Phil Simms with hair.
1988.
Here and
here. Oh,
wow. I remember that day.
And for you.
Oh, what a great.
Awesome.
And one for anybody else.
Buffalo Brass.
Now, it is clear that you obviously love music.
Oh, yes.
Who are some of your musical inspirations?
Well, as a trombone player growing up, actually, the first band that I ever got interested in was the Tijuana Brass.
Oh, that's going back.
Because they had a trombone player.
Oh, I remember that, too. It's scary.
But there's just too many to mention. And fortunately, I was so fortunate, thanks to a good friend, Dennis Tribuzzi, who is an amazing Buffalo, New York trumpet player. He traveled with Doc Severinsen's big band, with the Dorsey Orchestra.
Awesome.
He's still one of the most sought-after lead trumpet players in the country. And Dennis was the one who called me up and gave me the opportunity to get out on the road with a bunch of the other Buffalo guys who were traveling. And through that experience, meeting so many people, I was just so fortunate, we all were, to meet just so many great, iconic people. However, the one that was really the coolest, I have to say, we played for President Reagan's inaugural,
both of
them. And the first inaugural, we were under instructions, you know, what to do when President Reagan got there. And all of a sudden, we thought he was there, but this gray-haired guy walks up on the stage, and it was Frank Sinatra.
Wow.
And, you know, who, of course, was in his early days a member of the Tommy Dorsey Orchestra. And everybody on the bandstand just did the big jaw drop. It's
like,
Frank Sinatra.
So that was
pretty cool. So very, very fortunate to be, to have good teachers and then be in the right place at the right time. And
now, you performed at the fair years ago with the Tommy Dorsey
Band
and blew the roof off the dome.
Well, we weren't responsible for knocking the dome down.
You were the summer storm.
We were the summer storm, yeah. The Dorsey Band, which it still is, I mean, run by Terry Myers now, a great clarinetist. But Buddy Morrow ran that band until he was 91 years old.
But could you share with us, you're back here at the fair with a couple different bands.
Yes.
And you're performing where and when?
We are performing at 7 o'clock each night until 8:30 at the Family Entertainment Complex, which, by the way, is the site of the old Music Dome. Mm-hmm. It's wonderful. It kind of aims right up the Midway or whatever that's called, you know, the main street there. And for the first two nights and the next two nights, it's the incredible Bobby LaBelle Orchestra, then Katie Miner and the Cabaret Big Band, the next four nights, and then Pete Cirillo's big band, all incredible local jazz musicians. Finish it off. And we're just so thankful to the fair and to Justin Iwanko, who reached out and contacted us and asked us to be here and to revive big bands at the fair. So we're delighted to be a part of that.
It's all on the fair website, all the information.
Yes.
I want to thank my Daily Buzz gals for letting me pop in here to hang out with my buddy Phil Simms. And Mercedes is going to come right back and take the responsibility back. But Phil will be so anxious to hear your music here, there, and everywhere.
Thank
you, Wendy.
We're
going to be right back, so please stay tuned.
Welcome back to the Daily Buzz 716. Do you think it's hard to find healthy food options here at the fair?
Yes.
Well, not anymore. Of course the judge would say that because she loves her donuts. But of course we're going to talk with our friends from Independent Health, who's all about healthy options. And of course it's the Healthy Options Program. And with us is the beautiful Miss Carrie Meyer, who is the executive director.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you. You guys are the beautiful ones.
Thank you. Isn't it healthy options that makes everything glow?
Either that or the foundation.
No donuts. No
in 2004, the Independent Health Foundation created Healthy Options Buffalo Program. Can you give us some background? Because Western New York had a lot of different things going on with high numbers of stroke and things like that. Mm-hmm.
Actually, I've been working with Independent Health for 23 years. I started as an intern there. And over a decade ago, we were talking about what do we need to do? How can we help, you know, the local community? And Healthy Options is a free program where restaurants could, you know, call in and we will help them analyze their menus at no charge. All the local, you know, chains like, you know, the TGIFs and the Outbacks, they have the resources to have a nutritionist analyze all their recipes. Well, these mom and pop shops here in Buffalo, they don't know what to do. And, you know, we're real famous for chicken wings and beef on weck and, you know, all these, you know, really unhealthy foods, but they taste great. And I'm not saying you can't eat those things, but we need to start, you know, watching what we're eating and healthy options evolved.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely agree. Now, you said 23 years you've been with this company, started as an intern. I'm all about interning early. Now, was it that early on that you decided that you wanted to make healthy choices?
You know, actually, my grandmother passed away, so, and she was obese. My mother passed away, she was obese too. So one from a stroke, one from heart condition. So, and I saw I was on her path, you know, and I struggle with my weight all the time, and I have to watch, you know. So I wanted to have something. You talked about earlier in the segment, people like to eat out, and it's good for them because they feel good about their life. I think you were
mentioning.
That
was the judge's idea.
So we eat out, take out, get a maid.
There it is. There
all
it
my
is.
Brilliant. I don't know what you do without me.
So if we get a maid, we're not scrubbing and using our muscles, and if we eat out, so we're not really eating that healthy. So we wanted to make sure that I eat out all the time. I'm busy. Women are working nowadays.
Yes.
So we're on the go. We have children. We, you know, we're hurrying and trying to get them something. We're running and getting a pizza. I wanted to have something that I can run and get that would be healthier.
What are some examples of what you did when you went to the restaurants and told them, you know, do this? I mean, we can guess, you know, don't fry the food. But right. There's probably a lot of tips you gave them and that you could give us.
Absolutely. So, I mean, you know, nowadays, I mean, there's a lot of foodies out there. We're pretty savvy. So we don't want to go to a restaurant that they have frozen vegetables. We want fresh vegetables. Mm-hmm. We want fresh fruit. We don't want a fruit cocktail out of a can. So, you know, I definitely try to encourage the restaurants, let's do fresh. And, you know, there's a lot of local farmers that you could go to and get the food from. So in the beginning, a lot of restaurants were hesitant. Like, if I'm no longer serving, you know, this onion dip or, you know, the blooming onion or, you know, my chicken wings, I'm not going to sell it.
Mm-hmm.
It sells. People are looking and requesting healthy options.
Now, talk about healthy options. You got this bowl of kale in your hand. Tell us about kale. Yeah.
Kale, yeah.
Yeah.
Kale, yeah.
Kale, yeah.
So you said it. You
kale,
said
yeah.
It.
No.
That's exactly how it started. So, you nailed
that.
When we brainstormed at Independent Health with a local agency, and we were like, we need to do something fun. Like, you know, nobody, like, they know they have to eat healthy. You know, they have to exercise, but it's hard. I struggle every day. So we need to make it fun, or people don't want to hear about it.
Right.
They don't want to be preached to. They don't want to be, you know, taught, you know, how to eat. They know how to eat. They want to try something fun and vibrant. So we were going back and forth. Has there ever been a healthy eating competition? So you know about all these eating competitions. So Coney Island has the hot dog eating challenge every year. They've been doing that for 100 years. Chicken wing contest. We have that here in Buffalo. So all these, you know, competitions, eating, but it's unhealthy. We're like, so let's call Major League Eating Association. Have you ever done a healthy eating competition? The answer was no.
No.
Wow.
There it
is.
So we wanted to be the first Buffalo to be on the map. Let's have a healthy eating competition.
Now, are we having this competition here?
We are.
And what type of foods are we?
So the healthy eating competition, you nailed it. Cal, yeah. So we were trying to come up with what's trendy. Cal's trendy. You know, what's really, really
that
healthy.
Stuff, that stuff you're
that
holding.
Stuff.
Is
this
that,
stuff.
Yeah.
The mayor,
green,
the donut.
The green stuff,
the judge,
the green
the
stuff you're holding.
Yeah.
So this bowl actually represents.
We
so last year was our first competition, and the gentleman that won, he's from Georgia. He ate 25 bowls of
just like that?
Raw?
Yeah.
Just
so,
like that.
So this is raw cow, but we did put a little bit of olive oil and vinegar on it just to massage it and not make it so difficult to chew and eat.
Well, I could do 25 bowls.
So it was like a salad. It was like a salad. Okay. Smoothie. We're going to be showing
you. I'm with that.
Mm-hmm. So pretty amazing.
People came from all over to do this.
Yes,
I'm so shocked.
So, yes, and we did it in 8 minutes, and there is an actual prize. So Major League Eating is an actual association, and people prep all year. year long to win these cash prizes. Mm-hmm. Joey Chestnut is the famous hot dog guy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he's going to be competing at the Erie County Fair on Sunday.
This is exciting.
In the Cal, yeah.
We're going to have to be there. Mm-hmm. Now, you talked about, you know, helping restaurants, but, mm-hmm. you know, what about cooking classes? Are you guys offering cooking classes?
We do. We have, so they sell out every year, too. We have two a month that we're doing, so now we're going to next year start doing them once a week. But we host healthy cooking classes and bring in different chefs from all different restaurants that are participating in the Healthy Options program.
Talk about how you guys are in the fair, because you're helping the vendors here, over 20 of them.
Yes.
Wow, it's amazing.
And we can find them by the orange sticker, correct?
Yes. So you can go on the Erie County Fair app, and they'll have a listing of all the healthy options. And there's 24 vendors that are participating, so we're so excited about it. Mm-hmm. I mentioned Healthy Options started over a decade ago, and it evolved into not only doing healthy options at restaurants and with food trucks, but at special events like the fair.
Yeah.
And people like the Taste of Buffalo.
They
switched to that, too. Mm-hmm. Every vendor has to have one healthy option along with the chicken wing option.
So the donut option for the judge.
So they participated with us, and they mandate every restaurant have a healthy option. So we're so pleased with that. We've been doing that for 10 years at the Taste. Second year at the Erie County Fair. Last year we only had 16 vendors. This year we have 24. So every year we want to grow it and hopefully mandate it as well.
Could you give us an example? Would you know?
Yeah, of what? I do. So there's 24 different vendors throughout the fair, and you have, you know, buffalo chicken wrap, a ranch chicken wrap. There's pizza, spinach and tomato pizza, a variety of different things that you wouldn't imagine would be considered healthy, but they are considered healthy.
Did you guys pick them, or did...
We worked with the vendors. We have a nutritionist on staff that works with the vendors. They can submit what they would like to provide as a healthy option, and then we might provide some alterations to make it, you know, fit the criteria.
So, I mean, one of the things you're trying to say is we could still eat pizza, or we could still eat whatever, but there's a healthy way to make it?
Yes. Okay. So, and I appreciate you saying that, because I'm showing this bowl of kale. I mean, nobody really wants to eat a bowl of kale.
Well, you know what? We're going to step into the room of kale in just a moment. So we want to thank Carrie for being with us. We're going to start eating. Hell yeah. Stay with us, because we're coming back and we're talking about healthy options and eating some too. Welcome back to the Daily Buzz 716. Now, you see, I got the kale in my hand, so that means it's time for us to stop talking about it and eat about it. Oh, that rhymed, didn't it? With us, we have independent health nutritionist Shelby Braun, and
I am so
excited.
Hi, everybody. Hey, thanks for having me on here. I really appreciate it.
Now, share with us, what do we have on this beautiful display that we're going to destroy?
Okay, so we have a couple of things. We do have something in lieu of the kale competition. This is a kale smoothie that I think you'll be pretty impressed with. We also have ingredients for a healthy French onion dip, as well as ingredients for a red quinoa summer salad. So I'm going to take you through a couple of these. Hopefully we can get through all three, but we'll just play around and I'll talk a little bit about nutrition as I go through.
Let's do it.
So with the kale, the biggest thing is that kale is extremely high in a lot of fat-soluble vitamins, vitamin K, vitamin A, vitamin C. So we're getting a lot of fiber, we're getting a lot of antioxidant benefits, and it helps with prevention of cancer. So it's a really wonderful thing to eat.
My mother this.
We can saute it, we can blend it, we can wilt it down into soups. So what we did today was blend it. We did 2 cups of kale. You can use the large full-grown kale. It does have stalks that are pretty bitter, so what we opted for instead is baby kale. It looks a little like spinach, but a little more frills on the end. This is a little less bitter, so it helps with the way the mixing with the fruit.
Now, is it
in there.
Better to eat baby kale if we were to do like a salad versus this kale?
It sounds like it, right?
Yeah. I think that as far as our palate goes, we don't need that tartness of the
Ooh, I tried it before.
I love sauteing that, putting it in my omelets in the morning, putting it in my tacos. So those are really nice ways to wilt it down and have that balance out
nicely.
We
have to try a piece of kale.
You want to try?
No, try the kale. Wait,
try the kale?
Yeah, try the kale. Come on, judge.
All right, you're talking into it.
I'm with baby kale. I'm not with the grown-up kale.
Tastes healthy.
Well, wait till you try the smoothie. We've also put in pineapple and banana and then some almond milk. We always want to go for the unsweetened almond milk.
Why? I always get sweetened.
Yeah. Mm.
Sweetened has added sugar in it. So we are allotted 6 teaspoons of added sugar in a day.
I thought I was doing something
great. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks, Joey. Here, we'll put no problem. Down, so. Try it. See if you like it. Here, you want this cup.
I'm sure
here.
You'll like this better, Judge.
There you go. Oh.
Now I'm going to taste this a little bit. Yeah.
Ooh. Much
Amazing.
Better with the fruit in it, right?
Yes.
No added sugar, all of the sweetness coming from the fruit. Yeah. So it's a nice way to balance and round out that kale.
Yeah. This is
awesome.
Really good.
Yeah.
Let's get
really
over
good.
Here. We talked about the kale. What we got next?
So we're going to do the quinoa salad next.
Ooh.
We have red quinoa here. Quinoa comes in 3 different colors. We have white, black, and red. There's really no difference in the nutritional property. It's just a beautiful aesthetic. So you can
why
is that good for you?
Why is quinoa? Oh, yes.
We all want to know.
This is considered a whole grain. We want whole grains for the high fiber. This is also an excellent source of protein. This is considered a complete protein because it has all essential amino acids in it. So this is, you know, something that a lot of people who are cutting back on their meat intake or who are vegetarian or vegan, this is a wonderful option to substitute in.
Okay.
So this is going to be a high protein salad. What we did is we cooked the quinoa in advance. You can boil it in water, which is what we did. You can also put it in stocks, vegetable stocks, chicken stock. It adds that little extra bit of flavor, but we do want to be going low sodium stock whenever we're cooking with stock.
Okay.
Next, we're going to add 2 tomatoes that are diced.
All right.
We're going
to
add in.
That's 2. Those are some
good
tomatoes.
That's 2. Yeah.
Those are 2 big
avocados. Yeah, we all love it. That's a nice healthy fat.
That's good for you, right?
Yep. That's a nice healthy fat. It's a good saturated fat. You can take that, use it in substitution of butter in a lot of places.
Okay.
So putting it on your toast in the morning is a nice option.
You have chips.
And you can put it on your face.
You can. You can moisturize. You're right.
I knew that.
I did 12 ounces of frozen corn. It's wonderful in the summertime that we can utilize fresh corn.
Yeah.
The nice thing about frozen corn, any frozen foods actually, especially the vegetables, is that it's almost like putting the pause button on all of the nutrients that are in it.
Oh,
so in the wintertime, when things are out of season, buying frozen, you're actually going to get better nutritional value out of it.
You know, for a long time, I guess I was misinformed that you shouldn't buy frozen vegetables. But now with you saying what you're saying, it makes sense.
Yeah. We're going to do about a half cup of green onion, right?
Ooh,
nice little.
They make everything look pretty. Yes.
They do.
Yeah,
it's really beautiful. And then we have some cilantro. So we're going to put that all in.
Tasty.
And then all we do is mix it together. I should have gotten a bigger bowl.
It's okay.
But we have a lot of color in here. The more color we have,
the
love thinking of our produce as a multivitamin.
Mm-hmm.
And the more color we have, the broader range that we're going to get in our vitamin intake. So mixing that together, it's beautiful. It smells great.
Mm-hmm.
Last but not least, we're going to use, we got this at Tops. It's a wonderful product. It's a lemon vinaigrette.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
so
they used to call me that when I was in grammar school. They couldn't get my last name right. It would be
vinaigrette.
I'm like Vivarette.
Vivarette.
That's great.
I'm calling you that from now on.
Like,
so we're going to do about a half cup and then just blend that in. It's beautiful. You don't have to use the vinaigrette. You can make your own with some lemon juice and some olive oil. You can also make different citrus flavors in there. So mixing up lime, mixing up oranges or ruby grapefruit, you know, any of those would add a really nice citrus flavor to it.
Okay.
It's a nice fresh summer salad.
Right,
so we have that available.
We have to taste it. We have a couple minutes left.
Okay.
We'll taste that right afterwards.
Okay. And as far as our onion dip goes, what we did was we sauteed a little bit of, let me just use this bowl here. I have one here. We sauteed a little bit of onion and garlic, so that helps break it down, caramelize it. It brings out a different depth to the flavor that we can have in this. You can keep it raw if you'd like. Just understand that there's going to be more of a bite to it. It's going to be pretty potent. We're also going to do a cup of fat-free Greek yogurt.
Really?
This is what you can swap anytime
sour
for sour cream.
Right?
Exactly.
Yep. It looks like you know your stuff, Jen.
Yeah.
I think it's all a front. She's really a healthy eater.
She really is.
But not a cook.
Okay.
We have banana peppers. We have jalapenos. So we're going to add a little kick in there. We're also going to put in, we can put in seasoning, salt-free seasonings like Mrs. Dash. We can do onion powder, garlic powder, any of those things that you can sprinkle in. It's a wonderful way to, again, add flavor. Also, we can take lemon zest. You know, I have a microplane right here, so we can just zest it down.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
She knows
what she's doing.
Yeah, she does.
I try. I got it, right? It's my job. Yeah. And then you can add other things, and we have basil, we have chives, we have parsley. Especially in the summertime, you can really create this and bulk it up as much as you want. Mm-hmm. The more that you add in, the larger the volume, the broad range of flavors that you have, and it comes out really nice. Oh, and we also add just a splash of Worcester.
This
is another example of something that you're making an unhealthy thing, which is onion dip, I guess,
or right.
onion dip,
right.
into something healthy. Yep. By changing a few things.
And that's to dip, so we can go ahead and try some of it. Yeah, so, but here's our beautiful little onion dip here. Yeah, and it's quick, it's easy, you throw it together.
Oh yeah, I'm trying.
Go ahead and dip, Marcy.
Those are so pretty. I thought they were fake.
Nope.
Sure? Oh, no, they're real.
Sure you're
they're real.
You sure that's real?
Mm. Okay.
You sure it's real? Well, of course, it's time for us to eat, for us to definitely taste. Mm. And we want to thank Shelby Brown for coming
with us, showing us some healthy options
here at the fair. And of course, we're going to eat while we take this short break. So stay with us. Welcome back to the Daily Buzz 716. It's our favorite time of this episode and every episode while we're at the fair. It's taste time, eat time. Mm-hmm. And what have they brought with us today?
We have collard greens. One of my favorites.
I eat every Sunday.
Mm. Could you tell us why this is good for us?
So when I spoke with Dre, what I do is I work with the vendors and we talk about what ingredients we include in it. He used, instead of ham, he used a turkey leg.
Oh, that's awesome.
So that was a nice leaner way to still add flavor in from that fatty turkey leg, but not have it be the ham where it's high in sodium. He also did it in a water-based broth where he just soaked the turkey legs in with it. Collard greens themselves are a wonderful dark leafy green. Again, high in antioxidant properties, high in fiber. They're fabulous for regulation. So an overall excellent choice as far as getting some
vitamins. What do you mean regulation?
Regularity with fiber.
Mercedes loves to talk about fiber.
And of course, these greens are from Dre's place. And all I gotta say is, I normally only eat my mother's greens.
Oh my gosh, this is so good. I can't give my mother
a run for her money. Nobody tells her that I said that.
Never had these at the O'Connell household. Just so you know.
You never.
Everything else was green in the house, but nothing that we could actually eat that wasn't expired.
Now, and speaking of our household, it's time for us to check in with the lucky number. And if you visited our gazebo here at the Erie County Fair and picked up a lucky number card, it's time for you to take a look and see if you are the winner. And our lucky numbers for today is 366. I feel like Yolanda Vega.
It is
366. Okay, so if you picked up a card, make sure you make your way to our studios in Eastern Hills during regular business hours to claim your prize. Remember, no purchase is necessary, and you must be 18 years of age, of course, to win. Now, be sure to tune in daily to the 716 Daily Buzz, of course. Monday, we'll continue our live show right here in the Cook's Kitchen and Shop at the Erie County Fair. And visiting the fair, look for us Monday through Friday from 10 to 11 a.m.
Now, before we go,
go ahead.
Can you give some tips to the folks at home that say, what I don't necessarily maybe like some of these items. Can you give some tips, healthy tips for folks that are beginning?
Sure. Yeah. So
we need slow and steady, right?
Exactly. When we dive in first, we tend to overdo it, right? It's we go all or nothing, and usually we set ourselves up to have some setbacks. Exactly.
And go get a steak hoagie.
So what I recommend is one swap every time you pull something from your pantry, every time you pull something from your fridge. When you go back into the store to replace it, try to go for one healthier option. See how it works. We don't have to go whole wheat pasta instantly. Maybe buy a box of regular pasta, of whole wheat, mix it together, you know, sample some things. See how it works. If you can make one healthy switch each week, you're doing a good
That's
job.
A great idea.
Yeah, it really
just
is.
Going nice
and also, you mentioned fresh and you mentioned method of preparation.
Right.
I think people, if they could start cooking differently, right?
Right, exactly.
Or preparing it differently.
Yep, exactly. When we cook at
at home, we really take our health into our own hands. So if we can, that's the ideal goal. We do have healthy options, so that is something to fall back on. If you are going out to eat, you can make sure that you're having good choices that you can stand by without falling off your health bandwagon.
And this is all the farm to table.
Right, yes.
The current and the current old-fashioned trend.
Yeah, you know, exactly.
Where people are actually having dinner together.
Right.
And
yes.
Cell phones are being put down. And,
right.
And
buying
fresh vegetables
fresh,
are being
local.
Ingested.
Great. Yep, exactly. That's
and
the
here at
go.
The fair, look for the healthy options with what
date? The orange,
what
orange
color?
Sticker.
Oh, going to be an orange sticker. And we'll have it listed. It's also on our website. It's also on the Erie County Fair app. So you have a couple of ways where you can look it up and see, you know, what you're near and what you can
absolutely. And
this
don't forget,
is awesome.
To go to, oh, yeah, that smoothie.
Good?
Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah.
And you just introduced me to something new, Baby Cal. So I'm so happy.
Good.
Again, thank you, Shelby.
Thank you so much. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you to Dre's Place for providing the greens. And we are just so happy to be here. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for watching the Daily Buzz 716. We'll be back again on Monday, so make sure you tune in.
What do you think?
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
This is good.
Yeah.
This is so good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Did you try this, Adriana, with the red quinoa?
No, I haven't. I'm about to.
Is there anything on it?
Come on, vinaigrette.
This is my first time touching
we did
this.
Come on, vinaigrette.
That's right.
No, seriously. The
simply dressed
like
lemons.
Adriana, vinaigrette.
Mm-hmm.
What? Like, lady, are you just hungry? Why are you calling me vinaigrette right now, lady?
That's very good.
No spoon, but I'm going to put it right on the tail.